Ciao, friends. If you use Power BI and write DAX, you probably know the built-in functions of the language. But imagine having access to external reusable libraries of DAX functions, ready to use into any semantic model. That's exactly what DAX Lib is, an open library of user-defined functions designed to improve your productivity writing DAX code. In real projects, we often repeat the same logic for dynamic format strings, special filters, date, transformations, custom visualizations, and much more. Without good reuse mechanisms, you end up copying the same code across many models, and maintaining that becomes painful. DAX Lib solves this problem. You import a library once, and from that moment, you can call its functions just like any native DAX function. Let's try an example. Welcome to daxlib.org. This website has a homepage where we can just make searches. For example, I want to search something for my format string, or for the conversion, convert, or for example, SVG. I want to create elements with SVG for my measure. So there are a number of libraries. We can also browse the packages of libraries by using this other page, packages. And what I want to start from is, I want to start from some conversion. Because for example, let's take a look at a report I have. In this report, I have this measure, year-over-year percentage, and I would like to create a custom format string with some symbol to display, for example, a triangle up or down depending on the sign, positive, negative, or maybe something green, red, or different color, different shapes. So maybe there is something already done instead of creating this from scratch. So let's go back to our DAX Lib. I can search here also in the packages page for format string. Oh, we have DAX Lib format string. Let's take a look. So here we have a description of the library. It's a very short description, but let me show you another example of a more recent library that already has a longer explanation, a longer documentation. We also have links to external pages. Let's go back to our format string, and let's say that I want to see this library. I want to see the code of this library. I just click on code, and I can see the code of the library, which is the Tyndall version, the Tyndall file, the Tyndall definition that I can input into my model. You see that I can click on this button, copy to clipboard, or when I click on add to Power BI, I can also click on this copy button without having to access the code in case I trust the library author. So let's copy it, which is the same thing that I could have obtained by clicking here, and I can go back to my Power BI file. I go to the Tyndall view and I paste the code and I click apply. What happens at this point, all of a sudden, my semantic model has all the functions of the library. You can see the list of the functions here. So all these functions can help me writing dynamic format strings. So I can go back to my report, I can choose my measure, say year-over-year percentage, and I want to change the format string to something that is more dynamic. So let's go to dynamic. And this is the default format string we have. I want to change it with a format string that shows a symbol after the percentage. So I think that it was a relative to target. Let's see if I just have to use this one. Okay, relative to target percentage. This is probably the function I saw at the beginning when I opened the library, and you see that in the help I can see some documentation, some description of the parameters I can use. So for example, in this case I want to use this as a suffix. I want to provide two decimal places, and I want to provide one of those symbols, triangles for example. So triangles. And then I have other two parameters, custom prefix, suffix, but these are optional, so I can use empty string, and let's go. So here we go. I have my triangles. That shows a triangle up if it is positive, down it is negative. Maybe I don't like the lack of the negative symbol here, but at the moment I don't want to investigate too much. I just wanted to show how to use the function. And for example, if I have to change a parameter here, for example, let's use the blue orange, so it's more evident which one is negative. Here we go. So these are negatives, and so they are highlighted better this way. So that's just an example of how I can import a library of functions, a library from a package from daxlib.org, and I can use the functions by just writing the code in a measure, in the dynamic format string, or in any other place where you can write DAX code in your model. In this video, we focused on the consumption side of DAX Lib, how to import and use a library. But what if you want to contribute? What if you want to publish a new library? Check out the documentation, which provides different instructions and suggestions based on the library size. Thanks for watching and enjoy DAX!